In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a reactive audio spectrum in After Effects. So let's get to it. First, I'm going to create a new composition. It will be 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second. Set duration based on the length of the song you're going to use, then click OK. Then drag the song or any audio file of your choice to the timeline. Then create a new solid, so layer, new solid. The color doesn't matter, click OK. Then open Effects and Presets window, search for audio spectrum, and add it to the solid. Straight away you'll see this line of dots appear, but if you scroll forward nothing is going to happen just yet. Now head over to the effect controls panel, and the first thing we want to change is the audio layer. So open the dropdown and select the song that you've added to the composition. Now if we scroll forward, the spectrum will react to this audio, but it looks very lame at the moment, so we're going to adjust the settings so it looks better than this. First we have the start and end point of the spectrum. We can control the position of it, or even give it a custom path by adding a mask. So let me quickly create one. So if you had the mask like this, you would open the path dropdown, set it to mask 1, and now the spectrum would be applied to this custom shape that you've created. If that's something you like, it's here, it's available. But I'm going to remove those and keep it at default settings. Then we have the start and end frequency, and this is the frequency threshold that the spectrum is going to react to. Basically, the higher value you put for the end frequency, the less reactive and jumpy the lines are going to be. I would keep this to like 600 or so. It should look good enough for this type of song. Then we have the frequency bands. You can control the amount of bands you have. If you go too high, at some point the lines will blend together and look like one solid piece. If that's something you like, you can go for it. But I'll set mine to 100 just to have a decent amount of bands available. Then we have the maximum height. You can control how high these lines are going to go. I'll set mine to 1000. That should look good enough. I'll skip this part for the audio delay and offset. Then we have the thickness, which controls the thickness of the band pretty much. I'll set this to 8. Then we have the softness, which introduces a blur around the bands. So if you don't want blur, you can remove it altogether by setting softness to 0. Or if you increase this to 100, it looks very, very blurry. I'll keep it at 50. It helps blend the colors together. Then we have the inside color, which is the fill, and the outside color, which is the stroke here. You can choose any colors of your choice. I'll set the inside color to be a very bright blue, and for the outside color, maybe a bit of a purple like that. Then we have the hue interpolation. As we start dragging the slider, extra colors are being introduced based on the hue cycle. You can see that. And you can drag this as many times as you want to get more colors over and over, but I would keep this at around 90 degrees just to have a slight color shift. Then we have the display options. You can have it at digital as it is. Then we have the analog lines and analog dots, and each one gives you a different kind of look. I'll keep it at digital. And we also have the side options. By default, it'll be set to side A and B, which is symmetrical from both sides. If we set this to side A, you can see the spectrum will only react to the top side and not the bottom. And once you get to this point, we can preview the animation, and you can see that the spectrum is reacting to the song. It looks very, very nice. And this is one of those effects that doesn't really have one specific way of creating something. You just have to give it some time and effort until you find the look that you like and you're happy with. And also one thing I would like to cover here, you've probably seen those circular audio spectrums that are very popular to put on top of the music videos. So it is very simple to create one. Once you've come to this point of audio spectrum, you need to open Effects and Presets window, search for an effect called Polar Coordinates and add it to the solid layer. Then for the type of conversion, set it to Rect to Polar, then set interpolation to 100%, and now you can see the spectrum has the circular shape, but it has this massive gap in here based on the start and end points of the spectrum. So come back to these settings, decrease the start point until you bring the start point to this middle here, and then increase the end point until you bring the end to the middle as well. And you know, once you've aligned them, you should have a perfect circular audio spectrum. So if you preview this, you'll see that the spectrum is reacting inside of this circle that is based on the sides that we've chosen. So if you set side options to side B, it will react outside this circle. And now you can see it looks very, very nice. And here you could add a glow effect on top of this to make it even better. So let me search for glow. The regular stylized glow added to the solid. And you can see it looks brighter now. So if we set glow radius to say 50, you know, if that's not enough, you can select the glow, press Ctrl D, duplicate it, and now it makes it extra, extra blurry. So now if we preview this, now this is our circular reactive audio spectrum. And that's how you create one in After Effects. I hope you enjoyed and learned something in this tutorial. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next one. Peace out.